Okay, so today I'm just gonna talk real quick because it's Sunday and it's the eve before the big start again. Are the banks falling? Are the banks happy again? All of that. So this is more gonna be about desalination, and now the dream of desalination has been out there for just decades. Just decades and decades, it seems to have been there. And you're like, when is it going to happen? When is desalination going to take over so we don't have desertification any longer? So we can say, hey, enough of that Blythe, Nevada, enough of Battle Mountain looking that way. Well, we would just take all of Nevada. Can you imagine that? And just make it a green zone. Then you move it over and you take all of Wyoming. I know that's skipping a few, but yeah, you go all the way to Wyoming and make it all green. I mean, it's possible. It's now becoming something that is inexpensive. I just read a Twitter. It is 5 cents a gallon. It's now that possible. So we have like a major opportunity. And now you're thinking, well, we're exerscapers. And no, we don't need to be exerscapers. The exerscaping has actually been a harm. It's kept the cities, those exerscape cities in heat. And it hasn't allowed any kind of green zone. So w over there, and meanwhile, over there in China, we have entire regions of deserts that are being that are being turned into agriculture, the whole deal, and they're like Mojave, even worse deserts, and they're turning them into real green zones. So we know it can be possible. And there's not really a benefit to keep the world in desert. There's not a benefit. We actually don't want that. We want to have green zones as much as possible because it's the lungs of our earth. As much as it's exciting to see that coyote and the OK Corral, that dun dun yeah, that type of music, you're out there at the Western, that moment, you've got your pistol and you're out there in the desert. As much as that's exciting in the movies, we don't really require to have vast deserts. It's actually bad for our earth. We need to enhance. We need that desal. I had a design a long time ago that I even created. Was it desalination? How did I do that? I don't know. It was something. It picked up the water from the ocean, and then it ended up watering the fields. And then it had. Then the sheep went back and forth. And there is on a like a teeter-totter system on a bridge, and there were no human beings needed, and it was something about that. I was making some kind of a perpetual life experience if there were no humans, that the sheep themselves could still live on these two properties and prosper. But it was interesting. But it included at the top, it had a desalination system, like a desalinator. It was like a glass building, so it was really like a macabre, futuristic think ahead that the sheep were still going to be supplied food. And that the water supply was going to be desalinated just through the process of them going back and forth on their teeter-totter tunnels, and which helped crank up the water up the hill. So it was kind of a funny one, but that just brings it back as to, oh yes, desalination. Because I came up with that like years and years ago, and that was a funny one. But the point that I'm trying to say is, I see this all the time. I just got a message from a company that's saying, hey, we're going to we exerscape or whatever. And that's our landscaping process, and they were trying to sell it to me. It's almost like they missed it. They missed the point that we can green the deserts now. They missed the point. So obviously we don't have a pipeline of desalinated water from the Pacific Ocean into Odessa or somewhere. We don't have that, but there is a start for it. We can definitely do that. We don't have to be draining Lake Powell for Los Angeles. We don't have to do any of those things any longer. We can actually grab that water out of the ocean and create a completely different landscape. So it's very exciting news that the costs have come down. And that's all I have to say today. And yeah, that was it. Is there anything else with that desalination that is a benefit? I mean, obviously, obviously for crops, it's all going to be about the outlay of getting the water through a pipeline to specific, and that can be through water trucks, that can be through pipelines. So it has a big potential, and the sooner the better, of course. And maybe this is one that Bill Gates would get in on, because I know he's hunkered down in GMOs lately, and so everybody's like, what are you doing? Don't do that. Yeah, I guess he didn't get it. He didn't get that advertising campaign that said, hey, we're not doing GMO, we're not going GMO anymore. You see, it says no GMO. He didn't get it. He's going with the others. So Monsanto and some other company called Suzuki or somebody. Yeah, so he's going through those, and I don't know, tumors on rats. They create tumors on rats, GMOs. So why he goes that route when he's all into pharmaceuticals, I don't know. Maybe he's into the pharmaceutical that stops the tumors on the rats as well. And so then it turns Bill Gates into a big evil villain. And I didn't want to see him that way. So yeah, so he needs to stop that marriage with his GMO system. But he normally is one that's very good for fresh water supply. And this will also stop that heinous filtration system of the sewers. What goes into the sewer system ends up in the drinking supply, just as a recirculated water, which is on the table from a lot of cities, and already I believe happening. So yeah, and hopefully the desalination will stop that process. We don't want that to be the norm. We actually want to get away from that kind of Soylent Green style, Soylent, yeah, that Soylent Green style of, eat your own selves. That's not really a way forward. It's just kind of a devourer of the human. So yeah, we don't want that version of a future. We want something that is, and yes, it's a resource, and yes, it is our ocean water, and yeah, we'll be taking it, but it's something that we have a vast, vast supply of, and it makes sense in comparison to the number of humans. So very good news. So if you are out there and you have money to throw at it, I would suggest jumping in on those businesses right away.